Hey guys, welcome back. In this lecture, I will be talking about making decisions in your codeless logic, which is the cornerstone of pretty much any program that you would write, whether it's with code or with codeless. And the core element to this is using the if statement, where you basically would be evaluating an expression to make a decision of what's going to happen next. Making decisions in your codeless logic is very simple. Of course, the decisions that you will have to make in any given program, they may be quite complex, but in the core of it is going to be the basic if-else statement. The if block is located in the logic category. It's the first one right here. Let's bring it out and take a look at it. So here you will see that it contains this connector right next to if, and in this part, this is where your expression, logical expression, will go that will be evaluated. And the way this works is that whatever you put in here, if it evaluates to a Boolean value of true, then this block inside, right next to the word do, will be executed. Very simple. And it will grow from there to something more complex that we will be going over. In one of the previous lectures, we talked about determining type. And then for this example, I would like to create a logic that will produce the output of what individual value is and display the type of that value. So for this, let's create a variable, and we will call this variable myData. And let's set this variable value to some, let's say, string, and we will be playing with it just to change it to other values. So let's say that the myData variable value is going to be a string with the value Bob. And in here, in the if statement, we need to basically do the check for the type of that value. In the logic category, we do have this block, you should be familiar with it by now, that essentially checks the type of a value. Let's connect it to the if connector and bring our variable into this type checking operator. Notice that it connected right away, and simply because Codeless knows that the result of this block is going to be a Boolean value. So anything that is a Boolean value can be connected to this if. In fact, if I take just a string, which is not a Boolean value, it cannot connect to it. You see, it just does not allow that connection because Codeless knows that this block is not a Boolean value. So here we check if my data, let's say, is of type string. And in this case, it is going to be a string. So what we can do is we can print out the result and say my data variable is a string. And this will work simply because this evaluates to true, my data contains string, and then do will be executed. Let's run it just to confirm. And yes, we get the result that the my data variable is a string. What happens if the my data variable is not a string? So for instance, if we take a number and assign it to my data and change it to some numeric value, then this block will not evaluate to true because my data contains a number. In this case, this will not be printed out at all. In fact, this block of logic will not even be executed. As a result, there is no output. So how do you enhance this block to check for other types? Of course, one of the options is to start adding additional if blocks, but in here, you will see, and this is the first time we actually see a block that has this capability, there is this little gear icon. So if you click on that, it gives you an option of expanding your if block with some additional branches of logic checking. So here, we can actually connect it with this else if, and notice what happened, that this if block now has this else if, and then we can add other conditions to check. So if my data, we are checking for string here, we can check for number. And then if it happens to be a number, then we will print out that my data variable is a number. And in this case, what should happen? So now it determines that this is a number. Likewise, you can continue adding additional else if branches to your if block to cover all possible scenarios. And then in this case, to make it more universal, we can check for string, number, for Boolean, we can check for undefined. Let's see, let's check for object and add corresponding print statements. In this case, this will be Boolean. And in this case, it will be an object. And let's say that we have covered all the scenarios. We covered pretty much all of them. We're not checking for arrays yet, so we're not even gonna go there for now. But you checked for everything. And then what happens is, whenever there is one remaining option that is there, it doesn't really make sense to do another else if. In this case, you can just add the else, which is kind of the final branch of logic. So we have explored all our options and we know it's not a string, it's not a number, it's not a Boolean, not an object. And in this case, the only other possibility that this value will be undefined is undefined. In fact, if we remove the initialization of my data completely, which means that it will be undefined, and we run this logic, it does say my data variable is undefined. So it made checks for all of these parts, and it finally went into this final one, which is else, and then that's what got printed. One interesting thing with the if else statements is that whenever a condition is evaluated, if it evaluates to false, then the corresponding do part is completely skipped. It's not even executed. Nothing happens to it. It will basically continue checking all those else if statements until it finds one. And if it didn't find one, then the else, if else is present, will be executed. This can get very complex, and you can add expressions of whatever complexity that your application requires. And that's basically how it goes. Now, let's come up with something that is more complex, that has kind of more additional checks in those if statements. And in here, we will create basically a simulation or more of a calculation for the rock, paper, scissors game. And for this, I will introduce two variables. The first one will be player one, and the second one will be player two. And then what these variables will contain, they will essentially contain whatever the choice that each individual player made. And I will keep this in here just so you have it in front of you in the video, in case if you were following along and you just want to go back and play with it. But the second part will be execution of the rock, paper, scissors. So let's set the variable of player one to a value, which will be whatever that player decided to be. So let's say this player selected rock, and then the second player selected scissors. Now we have to create those if statements that essentially do all the checking of comparing rock with scissors, and then paper with rock, and so on, to determine who won, player one or player two. In fact, this, we need to change this to player two. So let's add our if statement. And in here, we basically need to decide what player one has and what player two has. And depending on what the selections are, we will determine whether player one won or player two won. Okay, and in here, what we will do is, using this block right here, notice that we can check two different parts and connect the two together with AND or. In this case, we will use AND. And this is how it's going to go. Notice what I'm doing is I'm basically checking whether player one has value rock, and if player two, let's show it, copy this thing right here. So if player one has rock and player two has scissors, then player two won. And in fact, let's report it back. player to one. Now, there may be other conditions, so let's add another else if. And in here, we can replicate this and then cover another scenario. So if player one has rock and then the player two has paper, then player one won. Right? Now, if we have another condition, what if player one selected scissors? And then player two selected scissors. And in this case, it is a draw. It is a draw. And actually, in this case, when player one has rock and player two has paper, player two has won. And then, by the way, here, it's going to be player one that wins because rock wins over scissors. And that's how it's going to go. So you basically can spell out all the individual conditions. Of course, this is not the most optimal way to do it from the algorithm perspective. There are more elegant ways to do it. And I'm doing it here just to demonstrate how you can create more complex and composite conditions. Let me just review it one more time. Rock over scissors. Rock wins, which is player one. Rock over paper. Paper wins over rock, so player two. And if both scissors, it is a draw. Let's take a look. And then we see player one won. So player one has rock. Player two has scissors. Rock wins over scissors. And that is correct. And that's how it's going to go. So under logic, once again, you have this if block. And then there are some additional things, like, for instance, we use this one to concatenate two different Boolean expressions together. The not block negates a value. So if you got true, and then if you do not, it will become false, and vice versa. And then this one is really a shortcut for the if. So you basically check on this one. You put the Boolean expression into the test connector. And then if that expression evaluates to true, then anything that is connected to this true is executed. Otherwise, if it is false, then anything you connect to the false gets executed. We will be using that block in the coming lectures as well. So that's your conditional statements, and we will be using them a lot because now we can actually start doing some very interesting things as we go along. Thank you for watching this video, and as always, happy Codeless coding.